Hi, this is Beatrice with Parole Amate at ICC and the letter N. And with N, maybe predictably, I chose nostalgia. Nostalgia nostos, return, and algos, pain, dolore, the pain of returning. I immediately associated that word with the Odyssey, Odysseus, thinking it was a Greek concept. When in fact it was coined very recently, in a sense, at the end of the 17th century, by this Alsatian, Alsace, French medical student, and it was a medical term originally. He applied it to Swiss soldiers who experienced depression-like symptoms when employed in foreign armies. They were missing their motherland. That's the idea. And he had three words that he was toggling between while writing his medical thesis. And one was nostomania, so the mania for return. One extremely long was philopatridomania, which emphasizes more the idea of a place of origin, patria, motherland, and then nostalgia. But it stayed a medical term until late in the 19th century. When then through poetry, it started to be seen as this larger desire for, people or things or places where we would like to come back, situations perhaps already lived, but that we would like to live again. And the poet Carducci, for example, talks about nostalgia dell'infinito, this more existential nostalgia for the infinite. I am very well versed in nostalgia, like many who live in between worlds, and maybe Parole Amate is an example of that. Nostalgia tends to grow with the years away and not dissipate, and perhaps that's why a lot of older people tend to want to go back to their place of origin towards the end. And it has its dangers. First of all, because I think you confuse nostalgia for a place with nostalgia for a time. So when I'm nostalgic for Italy, it could be nostalgia for an aspect of my childhood. And in the political arena, it can become a fantasy. Nostalgia for the past, a kind of rhetoric for in favor of an imagined past that most, if not all, authoritarian regimes tend to employ. One of them being, of course, the fascist regime in Italy. And, in these books, these etymological dictionaries I look through, under nostalgia, there's a long section about i nostalgici del regime, sometimes just called nostalgici, so those who were nostalgic after the end of World War II and fascism, those who were nostalgic for that phase, for those 20 years of horrid regime, which is so a system, right, built on nostalgia, then also could be invested with its own perverse fantasy of nostalgia. It's another subtle nostalgia that I found in this beautiful short story that was partially, I think, translated in the New Yorker too a few months ago by Natalia Ginzburg. Inverno in Abruzzo, winter in the region of Abruzzi. And she, incredible writer, Jewish father, she got married with Leone Ginzburg, who's the co-founder of Einaudi, and openly running anti-fascist activities and being himself Jewish. And they were part of an incredible intellectual circle that included Cesare Pavese, the writer we touched on a couple of letters ago. And then, because of these fascist activities, they were condemned to Il Confino, internal exile, and they ended up in a very small, poorly resourced village in Abruzzi. And missing their life. They had these three children, but missing their lives. And so, some of the things Natalia Ginzburg touches on is that the seasons are long, they're an extreme in this town. They buy oranges. She doesn't distinguish at first the different women who are around her with no teeth and less educated than her. And then little by little, she says, I started to recognize Vincenza, Secondina, and sit at their fireplaces. And she describes this exile as, you know, sitting and looking up at the ceiling in this house that was foreign to her, with the kids playing and the husband writing. And she looks at this eagle that was up, etched up there on the ceiling, and the people starting to ask, so when are you going back home? And also asking them questions. They were these strange presences in the village. And then what happened during this, at the end of these several years of exile, is that her husband Leone was caught and put in the German section of a fascist Rome prison, where he was horribly tortured and died at 34. And how she concludes the story, and I'm gonna conclude too with this, is a kind of nostalgia for a time that seemed a suspended, useless time that was not in line with their dreams, with their intellectual dreams. But she says, ma quello era quello il tempo migliore della mia vita, e solo adesso che m'è sfuggito per sempre, solo adesso lo so. But that was the best time of my life. And only now that it has escaped me forever, only now do I know it. See you next Monday.